it's weird because the Simpsons only have four fingers on each hand. The Simpsons should occupy a base eight world. The one thing I can tell you is that there is one character in The Simpsons who has five fingers. And this is why they live in a decimal world. A while ago, I began to realise that The Simpsons writers are very mathematical. They drop in bits of maths in the series over the last 25 years. And maybe the most common bit of maths that pops up in The Simpsons is pi. My favourite mention of pi is in an episode called Marge in Chains. And the episode revolves around the fact that Marge is accused of stealing something from Apu's quickie mart. And she's put on trial, and Apu is the main witness. And he's in the witness box, and Marge's attorney tries to discredit him by saying that his memory's not very good. Now, Apu responds by saying that, in fact, his memory is so good that he can memorize pi to 40,000 decimal places, and the 40,000th decimal place is one. When I met the writers, I said, oh, you know, so how did all of this happen? How did it work out? And one of them, I think it was Al Jean, said that he'd been aware of people's ability to memorize pi. And the record at the time in 1993 was 40,000 decimal places. So the reason why Apu claimed 40,000 was because that matched the record at the time. And I said, well, who figured out that the 40,000th decimal place was one? Because this is kind of going back to before Google and having things on tap. And he explained that what they did was they contacted a mathematician who works in this area, a chap called David Bailey, who is a world expert in pi. And David Bailey has actually invented a completely new way of calculating pi. But before we do that, maybe it's worth looking at some of the old ways first.
Let's do it. What have you got that bucket for?
To avoid my embarrassment at drawing circles, here is a circle generator. Whoops, there we go. Right, so if you want to measure pi, you need to know the diameter and you need to know the circumference. Now, the diameter is kind of easy to measure, but the circumference is much harder. And I think it was Archimedes who said, well, one way to begin to get a handle on the perimeter is to draw squares. So you draw a square around the circle and you draw a square inside the circle. Now, it's quite easy to measure the perimeters of a square, a small square and a large square, and you know that the perimeter of the circle must be trapped between those two numbers. And it's a very, very rough and ready calculation. It's really not a clever way to measure pi. But then imagine instead of using a square, you'd use an octagon. Okay, and the same thing you would do here. You put an octagon inside, like that. And so the more edges that the polygon has, the more accurate you can begin to home in on pi. And I think Archimedes used 96 sided polygons in order to home in on his value of pi. But that still doesn't get us very far. And so eventually people begin to develop formulae for working out pi. Leonard Euler, the 18th century mathematician, came up with pi to the fourth power over 90 equals 1 over 1 to the power 4 plus 1 over 2 to the power 4 plus 1 over 3 to the power 4 plus 1 over 4 to the power 4 and so on. And with this kind of formula, and there are lots of them, the more terms you calculate, the more accurate your value of pi. Now that's fine if you only need some of the early digits, but if you want the 40,000th digit, which is what Apu wanted, it's a lot of work. Now what David Bailey invented, which is really clever, is what's called a spigot algorithm. And a spigot algorithm, a spigot is a kind of a tap, an old-fashioned word for a tap, and taps drip, 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 drip. And a spigot algorithm will drip you whichever decimal place you want. So if you say, well, I want the 995th decimal place of pi, you tune the spigot algorithm and the 995th decimal place of pi drops out. And so they called the right guy. You know, the Simpsons team were talking to David Bailey, the real expert. You want the 40,000th digit, David Bailey will give it to you, except his spigot algorithm only works in hexadecimal. So it only works in base 16. So if you want pi written in base 16 to the 40,000th decimal place, and David Bailey can give you the answer. So in the end, what they had to do was, well, actually what David Bailey did was he just printed out 40,000 digits of pi and sent them in the post to the Simpsons office, and they referred to that in order to check that the 40,000th digit was indeed one.
The spigot algorithm sounds like a work of genius. Is it very useful, though? What person ever wants a specific digit of pi?
That's a good question. I mean, pi is... there are two reasons for doing mathematics. One reason is to solve problems. You know, we might call that applied mathematics, and engineers use it, and scientists use it, and everybody uses it in order to get something done. But the other half of mathematics is what we might call pure mathematics, and it's purely there for the love of mathematics, for the enrichment of mathematics. And I suspect that a spigot algorithm is really done for the love of it, for trying to understand this wonderful number we call pi. Two other things worth mentioning about Apu. So Apu's in the witness box. He's saying that he can remember 40,000 digits of pi, and that the 40,000th digit is one, and the Simpsons writers had got all this information from David Bailey and NASA. I tried to contact the writers of that particular episode, a guy called Josh Weinstein and Bill Oakley. And I didn't talk to Bill, but I did speak to Josh. And I said to Josh, I said, so you must be really interested in maths to put this in. And he's not a mathematician. And it turns out that when he wrote the script, there was nothing about pi in it at all. The attorney says to Apu, you don't have a very good memory. And Apu's response was nothing to do with pi. Apu's response was, oh yes, when I was in India, I was known as Mr. Memory. And there have been over 400 films made about my fantastic memory. And so the original script did not mention pi. But what happens in The Simpsons is that once you've done a draft script, you sit down around a large table with 8 or 9 other writers, and they pitch in. And at that stage, there were 1 or 2 mathematicians who said, well, why don't we make Apu's memory, why don't we define his memory by his ability to remember pi? So it was the mathematicians who then crowbarred that bit of pi mania into the script. The other interesting thing is that the 40,000th digit of pi is 1. 40,000th decimal place of pi is 1. But that's only in decimal. If you have other bases, you will have other digits popping up in that place. So by this stage, we're thinking, well, okay, the Simpsons world is a decimal world. And there's nothing wrong with that. My world is decimal, your world is decimal, the world seems to be decimal. In the Simpsons, however, it's weird because the Simpsons only have 4 fingers on each hand. And if you have 4 fingers, or 3 fingers and a thumb on each hand, let's do that, that's 8 digits. The Simpsons should occupy a base 8 world. So why are they messing around with pi in decimal when they should be messing around with pi in base 8, in octal? So when I was over in Los Angeles thinking about this and talking to the writers, you know, why is it that the characters have got 8 fingers? Why is this decimal? And I soon realized that 8 fingers in the cartoon world is a given. Mickey Mouse had 8 fingers. Felix the cat, I think, had 8 fingers. They all have 8 fingers, because if you have 5, it looks like a bunch of bananas, apparently. The one thing I can tell you is that there is one character in The Simpsons who has 5 fingers. And this is why they live in a decimal world, because the one character in The Simpsons who has 5 fingers on both hands is God. And God determines how numbers work, and therefore the numbers in The Simpsons are decimal, not octal.
In case you don't know, but you probably do if you watch Numberphile, Simon has a book out all about The Simpsons and their mathematical secrets. It has not one, but 2 chapters about pi. So why not check it out? And I'll put a link in the video description if you want to have a peruse of some reviews and maybe make a purchase. I've already got my signed copy. And of course, here at Numberphile, we've done loads of videos about pi in the past, and I'm sure we'll be doing more in the future. I'll put a link on the screen for anyone that wants to check some of them out.